And all of a sudden, the Lord seems to have descended from the highest pinnacle to a very ordinary world, saying that, for that matter, please don't tell it to somebody who is not tapasvi. The gap between the mantra previous and the current mantra appears to be quite yawning, quite wide. And then it does give a feel for somebody who is not reading it under the light of Gurudeva or person of Gurudeva's caliber, a feeling that how can Gita suddenly jump or stoop down to an ordinary level from an extraordinary height. That is the kind of feeling we get. But what needs to be understood here is, according to many, Gita has ended in the previous shloka. In terms of philosophical interpretation, to an extent they are true also, because it all started with shoka and ma shucha is where it has ended. But the fact remains that the final answer given by Lord is of such a different nature. It is from a standpoint of the partha who has reached the level of listening to this shloka and understanding it. Let us take a very common vyavaharika drushtanta. Ask any person who is 30 years of age, what is your idea about life? He would say, boss, money is very important in this life. You have to be first amongst everybody. Throw yourself into this world and make your mark on it. These are the sentences which you see from the mouth of a 30-year-old. Ask a 60-plus person and he would say that, kamao, kamane mein koi dikkat nahi, but money is not everything. What has differed from in the same person's life, what has changed is the outlook has changed, because he has realized through the experience a stage where he has started giving more importance to the happiness than money. Priorities have changed. The priority changed depending upon the level of understanding in a secular field also. Being in philosophical field, place where Lord is staying, the place where Lord is stationed, from that place the Lord is telling that sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam braja. Your dharma adharma, for that matter dharma is, there is a lakshana on dharma as ajnana. Dharmas, it is called jad lakshana. You have to completely abrogate the word dharma and take it as ajnana. That is called jad lakshana. What Lord is trying to say, that whatever you are talking so far, whatever secular knowledge I imparted, whatever I spoke to you, I told you about karma yoga, I told you about how to do karmas, I told you about hatova prapsisi sarvagam, everything I told you, but all that, the reason why he is abrogating whatever he has told so far, because the standpoint has changed. More progressed you are philosophically, the approach towards the universe or the world or the manifested world changes. That is why Ghalib's most famous sher, Ghalib was a Sufi, very few people understood him. He never spoke in normal language. Hame to malum hai jannat ki haqeeqat, lekin dil behlane ke liye ye khayal acha hai. I know what it means. So when it comes to that, the Lord is saying that, now, let us take example of Gurudeva. It's another drushtanta. What must be the standpoint of Gurudeva when he is performing his daily duties? He is performing all the daily duties with utmost scrutiny. But at the same time, papam, punyam, dharma, adharmam, all the dvandvas, they do not mean anything to him. He is dvandva atitam. Now, after telling such an esoteric, highest possible aspect of the philosophical knowledge, Lord realized one thing, that one whose bosom is pulsating with this knowledge, now he would be coming and, as in the words of Vivekananda, throwing itself like a lightning on the humanity. At that point of time, the Lord is giving a word of caution. This is a word of caution to whom? To that Partha who has understood 66th verse. Not for me. I am not in Partha's situation. And that is one of the reasons, if Swamiji's biography has been correctly read, there was a conflict before he took a decision whether he should be doing the Jnana Yajna or not. And it's not our argument. Two great Jivan Muktas have differed in the opinion. Both the gurus, one said, you go ahead. The other says, beware, you might get caught in karma. Think deeply about it and then we realize this mantra. That's why I do smell Swamiji's personal fragrance of his experience in the explanation that he has given. It has come somewhere from deep within the heart. And he was convinced about it because of the 68th shloka. So 68th shloka, we should all be thankful because Swamiji came back telling us what is what. Once this is sure, the word of caution given by Lord is with a particular purpose. Swamiji says, a rock will not yield the crop. What is that rock? Because it is in the stage of a rock only when it gets under the sunlight for a longer time and gets withered by the weather, gets converted into a clay, there will be a sprouting of the tree. Now when we come to this, the entire knowledge so far told is knowledge about what? Knowledge about manifested or unmanifested world. Brahman does not get comprised into it. Why? It is knowledge by itself. So far we were talking of knowledge of. We never spoke about knowledge. Knowledge of. Whenever we say knowledge of, it is referred as idam. That is why one of the famous mantras in all the yajnas is idam namama. Idam is when you are pointing out to that. When you say that, this has to be there. When idam comes, then that knowledge of idam, and then why do you need the knowledge of idam then if idam is not the ultimate? It is through the knowledge of idam that you go to tat. Through the knowledge of idam. So, Lord says, so far whatever I have told you, the gist of which I concluded or condensed in my previous shloka, idam, that knowledge, te na tapaskaya, idam te na vacham, that is how the connection is, to whom na atapaskaya. Who is that atapaskaya? What is that tapas? The first condition that is put as tapas, because tapas by word itself means heat. The reason why Agni has been given the most important place in the entire pantheon of gods is because the purification process or creation of something which is called as a Srujana Shakti is potent in the Agni. That is why sun is always worshipped. It is sun which gives rise to everything. After the sun basks the thing into that light, something else sprouts. Taking that is why tapasvi means born out of fire. There is also reference in Rigveda to that tapas, to a lady who delivers a child. There is humongous amount of heat in the womb and the embryo, and then the child is born. Even that reference has been given. So one who does similar kind of tapas to what? Tapaskaya, tapas to the body, because tapas is always of the body. Tapas is always of the body. So where do you start first? You start from the body. It is the sthula shariram. Now what does the body do? Tapas means what? I sit at one place. Is that tapas alone? When the body, mind complex, as Swamiji says. It says not mind body. Body mind complex. Body, because first is body. And what does body do? It executes. Yadi shariram na syat. There was no question. That is why when the Shrunkhala is told about this misery of life and death, the first question asked is, why do I have this sorrow and pain? The first explanation is because you have a body. Shariram, sharir nahi, nothing is there. So negation starts from sharir. So does that mean you neglect the body or negate the body? Negate the body, don't neglect. Shariram adyam khalu dharma sadhanam means the indriyas in my body which ultimately interact with this world, that is my first gate that I need to put a screen, filter. Putting this filter is a two-way function. One is let nothing come inside which shall disturb my nature of myself, or let nothing should move out from there to grab something. When I put a filter so that nothing should come inside, I am exercising dhamma. Vishaya, vraja, leave. Don't go to that lane where dirty things are happening. Dhamma abhyasam. Dhamma in Kabir's word is, man jata hai to jane de, tan mat jane de. Then the second filter comes of shama, where vishaya virajya vrata. Dosha drushtya muhur muhu. What is right, what is wrong? Vivek, application of vivek before a subject creates an impression on the mind is a shama. If these two are coming, then the person is doing tapas. Unless tapas is done and the chitta shuddhi is achieved, how will you understand what I am talking at sarva dharman parityajya? So do not, since you didn't understand it, you also don't give it to, or even if you give it to, thou shall not understand. Atapaskaya. Then what Shankaracharya says is taporahitaya, which is one on the same meaning. Now the question is, after idam is explained, one very good thing is, even if I do just tapas, I think that should also enough. Very categorically, that is where again we were talking about the same thing. Only the adhikari person's nirupan should be read. No one else should. Ye badhakaron ki masail hai. Sufi says, this is an area of drunkard people's discussion. Don't enter into it. Maikade mein har kisi ko fana nahi milti. The reason being, see what he has said. Tapasvine api abhaktaya gurudeva bhakti rahitaya kadachan kasyajit api avisthayam navacham. Even if you are tapasvi but you are not guru upta, navacham. Then it says bhaktaha tapasvi api san ashushrushaha yo bhavati tasmay api navacham. Acharya has very clearly said three together. Now let's put little tarka into it. Why three together? Can you be a tapasvi without a bhakta? It is like a person is swimming in the water but there is not a drop of water on his body. Cannot happen. Tapasvi and bhakti, because what we presume is bhakti is going. Swamiji has defined bhakti twice in this interpretation. And I have not come across such a beautiful definition. Identifying yourself with the goal is bhakti. There is no other definition for bhakti. Now the question is, there is somebody whose bhakta I am, so there is a distance. Closer I go, apni jagah se nikle, Dwarka pahunch gaye. Stage 1, Dwarka mein pahunche, Rana ji ka ghar kahan hai, Bake Bihari kahan rehta hai, unke mandir mein pahunche, one more step closer. मंदिर में गए, बाके बिहारी के सामने खड़े हो गए और उसके आगे गए, बाके बिहारी के गोद में बैठ गए. The process of reducing the distance between the goal and me or the deity and me is bhakta. Now this when starts tapa, and the reason why it happens is, what is tapa? Swamiji has given beautiful example. Non-dissipation of energy into that which is not conducive to my spiritual unfoldment. Now once I do that, what do I do with that so much of energy that I have? It is going to be directed towards the deity. Once it is directed towards him, then the energy is so proficient that it will push you towards. So tapas and bhakti is happening at the same time. Which one predominates? Difficult to say, because as you go closer to jnana, that is why bhakti is divided into jnana purva bhakti and jnanottara bhakti. In jnanottara bhakti, Lord has no choice but to be always at beck and call of bhakta. Bhakta Prahlad, Bhakta Pundalika, Tukaram Maharaj. It was not a question of they calling him. He was there in the service. Question is, it is like a genie who was looking at the master. What next? That is Jnanottara Bhakti. So, idam te na tapaskaya, na bhaktaya, kadachan never, kada api never, nacha ashushrushave. The meaning here of ashushrushave, even in Shankaracharya, Swamiji radically differs there. Not radically in that sense. He has taken it as lakshana. Swamiji ne iska jo lakshana kiya, usko bolte hai jad lakshana. Jad lakshana means you drop that word and take another word. मैं अभी अभी कल आपको मिलने के लिए आपके घर के ऊपर से ही निकल रहा था. Doesn't mean that he had climbed on the house. What you did, ऊपर से निकाल दिया आपने, घर के सामने से ले लिया, ऊपर से निकला सामने से आया. This is called jhad lakshan. So shushrushave, the word has come from shru. Shru means to give. Shru is to give. Now shushrushave is a typical grammatic thing that happens in Sanskrit, where first alphabet gets replaced by the same. Sushruve, shushrushave. Sh comes become sh. So shushrusha is to give. Give what? Su. The best that you have, you can give. What is the best that you have? Chaitanyam. Give it to whom? Another chaitanyam. Meaning, lend your ear. Now the question is, every time we say shravana, manana, shravana is what? Hearing. Hearing to roj kar rahe. Every day we are hearing. Shravana of the kind that is expected in this sadhana chatushtya is nothing else but lending yourself. And lending yourself itself has been beautifully done as a lakshana by Gurudev as serving others. When will you give whatever you have? When you know, I don't have anything. Bharo, bharo itna ke sab khali khali lage. Ya to duniya rahe ya aap rahe. Sufi says. Give it so much that because you've given your ego also, you don't know you gave. That is the had of giving. And then when that happens, nacha shushrushave vacham nacha mam yo abhyasuyati abhi asuyati. That is the vigraha. Abhi asuyati. Now, abhi asuyati, asuya. Mai adhyakshena suyate characharam. Suyate asuyate. Suyate say characharam means suyate is one who has decrepit tendency because I am not having it. If something that does not belong to me, the feeling comes in me, then that should be mine, creates a kind of a feeling in the mind which is called asuya. One beautiful woman, bhala meri sadi uske sadi se safed kaisi, is asuya. How it can be that she is more beautiful than me? Asuya. Now, when that asuya is taken, abhi asuyate, abhi means very close to. Abhi word has different, this abhi is going to come in the next mantra also. There the connotation is different, here the connotation is different. Abhi is closer. Abhi jnana shakuntalam. Closer to the recognition. Because in that Dushyanta got his key ring and all that. So he recognized abhijnanam. Abhinandanam. Abhinandana is to welcome. That is the question that they are asking in Kaun Banega Crorepati. What is a welcome word for Abhinandanam? Because you welcome somebody. Abhi is closer to. Abhi means continuity. So one who is continuously despising whom? The Lord. To do despise also, find between human beings. Jiva jada bheda. Jiva ishwara bheda is asuya. And when that happens, then vacham iti vyavahitena sambandhyate. Shankaracharya has added one line. Vacham means don't tell no. Keep it secret. There are two different things. One is don't tell. Another is keep it secret. Here what it says is keep it secret. And that is why Swamiji, when it comes to that one lines that Swamiji has given, these qualifications are essential adjustments. There are not restrictions. It has got nothing to do with the restriction. These are essential adjustments. And Swamiji says, those who do not live an austere life, that means those who do not have control over body and mind. That's what we said about Shamadama. About tapas, Swamiji said, you conserve, you preserve, and you redirect. How do you interpret it in vyavaharik life? Let us see where our energies are going. Except God, they are going everywhere. Because when you are standing in front of God also, they are going somewhere else. If that is so, then how do I conserve my energies? By simply avoiding the places where the energy may get dissipated. Where does the energy get dissipated? Undue talking, undue fighting. All vikaras dissipate energies very fast. Anger, money, continuous thinking about things that are not within our control is the highest dissipation of energy. Agar ye ho jata to wo ho jata, that is the maximum dissipation, because wo hota bhi nahi hai. To an extent, the stupidity goes to a level where agar hamare pitaji ne humko us school mein dala hua, ab pitaji bhi gaye, school bhi gaye, still the mind gets a tendency to go there. What difference does it make if Shah Rukh Khan has got wrinkles on the face or not? But it bothers me. Dissipation of energy. Bagal wali jo hai, uska uske bachcho pe achha control nahi hai, mera mere bachcho pe bahut achha control hai. Dissipation of energy. Dusra iskon mein ja raha hai, inko takleef ho rahi hai, iskon mein zyada kuch hota nahi, aap idhar aa jao. Dissipation of energy. Aprushta kasyachit bruyat, if not asked, don't talk. So dissipation, Swamiji says, once this dissipation is under control, the person who is spending money every day, he will always be wanting money. But person who has saved enough, now can think of investment. Then the investment, that is what redirection is Swamiji talking about. And then that redirection is coming where? I want to get up early in the morning. Yes, energy can be redirected there. Why? Yesterday night, till 12 o'clock, I did not dissipate my energy on 3 cereals in continuous way. So when it comes to that, the situation, our situation is, every time we dissipate the energy, we feel repentant about it, we do again the same thing very next day. Fir huye hai gawah ishq talab, ashk bari ka hukum jari hai. Again those witnesses have come forward, again my crying is going on, a Sufi says. That is why austerity is that. Then Swamiji talks about devotion. Those who do not have capacity to identify themselves with the ideal they want to reach, they cannot be devoted people. How much devotion should be there? Take Swamiji's own life as an example. One nimish, one kshana, you tell me where Swamiji deviated from his goal. Was it not that he was tired? Is it not that he would have felt that ek hafte ka break le lete? He deserved it. Much more deserved. Hum to kuch bhi nahi karte, every 6 months there is a break. So he must have, but it doesn't happen that way. Why? Because identification of with goal. Ek Sufi, Kabir Maharaj bahut achha bolte hai. You know how this devotion, sir, Kabir Maharaj describes it this way. If you get a small stone in your, peck, in your eye, it bothers you a lot. कंक कंकड़ी पड़त नयन में नयन होत बेचैन, उस नयनन में चैन कहां जिस नयनन में नयन। इफ माय आईज आर वन विथ हिज आईज एंड दे आर स्लाइटली सेपरेटेड, एक सूफी बोलता है ये सांसों ने बड़ी तकलीफ कर दी है, बीच में आते हैं, द ब्रीदिंग इज डिस्टर्बिंग, व्हाई बाय चांस माय अटेंशन गोज टू सास, सास पर नाम ले वृथा सास ना खोए, ना जाने इस सास का आवन होवे न होए। सो डिवोशन व्हेन ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट, दैट्स व्हाई स्वामी जी सेज दैट इट शुड नॉट बी अंडरस्टूड ओनली बाय इंटेलेक्चुअल मीन्स। काजी किताबे देखता देता नसीहत सबको, जब दर्द मरहम ना हुआ काजी हुआ तो क्या हुआ। एवरी डे द काजी इज टीचिंग इन मस्जिद बट हिज पर्सनल लाइफ इज फुल ऑफ, दैट इज व्हाट स्वामी जी इज पॉइंटिंग। एंड देन ही सेज टू हग ऑन टू एन आइडियल इन अ क्लास्प ऑफ लव इज डिवोशन। जब लग नाता जगत का तब भक्ति ना होए, नाता तोड़े हर भजे भगत कहावे सोए, कबीर बाबा से। देन टॉकिंग अबाउट द सर्विस दैट अशुश्रूषा पार्ट, स्वामी जी सेज दैट सिंपथेटिक लव। सूफीज में दो तरीके का प्यार बताया गया, इश्क ए हकीकी और इश्क ए मजाजी। हक ब्रह्मम, इश्क ए हकीकी, और दूसरा एवरीथिंग अदर देन ब्रह्मम, इश्क ए मजाजी। That is why everything that we do, बाबा फरीद का एक छोटा सा श्लोक है, मंत्र ही बोल सकते, he says कागा चुन चुन खाइयो, चुन चुन खाइयो मास। He was fasting for the sake of God and the fasting went to such a level that he was lying on the ground listless and the birds started coming to pick on his flesh. That is when he has composed this. कागा चुन चुन खाइयो, चुन चुन खाइयो मास, ये दो नैना मत खाइयो, जिन नैनों में उन नैनन की आस। इवन एट दिस स्टेज जस्ट लीव माय आईज, दैट मींस माय अटेंशन टू माय लॉर्ड, जस्ट कीप दैट इंटैक्ट, रेस्ट एवरीथिंग यू टेक अवे। दिस इज वेयर इट कम्स टू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ सिंपथेटिक लव। स्वामी जी फर्दर सेज, एंड दिस इज अबाउट कैविलिंग एटीट्यूड, दिस कैविलिंग एटीट्यूड is asuya, abhi asuyam, continuous hatred. And then Swamiji also takes it into something different level. He has given, there was one person who was Muslim, who was a devotee of Swamiji. And he was constantly behind Swamiji saying that, convert me into Hinduism. And Swamiji categorically said no. He was a Sufi. He is still there. I have read his literature. And in his literature, he has said it was Swamiji who made me learn Brahmajnana. Swamiji said, Swabhava Swadharma, carry on. You carry on what you are doing. The reason is because religion is not a matter of forceful conversion. And that is why here the difference is dichotomically opposite. In our religion, in 69th shloka, he is saying, keep giving. In fact, Swamiji says, if you cannot give, your intellect is definitely tar. While you go to any supermarket where there is a book called Quran, it is specifically written, do not open if you are not so and so. Diametrically opposite. The idea is not to criticize something. The idea is jnanam by its nature is a mobile thing. Swami Vivekananda said, amongst the dhanam, the highest dhanam is jnana dhanam. In that kind of attitude, Swamiji's none should expect an immediate result from the study of Gita. It's a clear-cut warning by Swamiji. Do not expect a change to come. It is a gradual process. Dheere, dheere, dheere re mana, dheere sab kuch hove. Mali siche sau gada, rutu aaye phalak hove. We need to wait for that. And that is why even Radha, when she's talking about Krishna, सावरे आईजेयो धीरे धीरे आईजेयो, she is also calling Krishna but come slowly. Why? I want to see you in a complete form. Metaphorically what she is trying to say is let me be graduate enough to that level where I can completely appreciate the Lord by itself. Look at Partha himself. At the level of Vishwarupa Darshana, he was not prepared. Lord is ready to give any kind of darshan. Is the sadhaka ready for that? So the steady evolution. And then the next shloka says, ya imam paramam guhyam mad bhakteshu abhidhasyati.